It's not 500 horsepower. Yellow extended aero pack, upgraded AP Racing brakes, fake taxi livery. I mean, that's a good job to have, right? Big ass wing, Poseidon. It's actually behaving quite nicely now. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are back with an update video on the Mercedes AMG A45 RS by Poseidon. Last time we drove this car, we had a Poseidon tuning box, so like a piggyback tuning box that they mainly use for export because it's easy to send it overseas to like Australia or the US or Brazil or whatever, because you know they can ship the car over and do an ECU remap and then ship the car back. So today they have tuned the ECU for us, and well, we're going to experience what the difference is. Of course, a tuning box is always going to be a compromise, so this is the best solution if you live in Europe, in my experience. So today I'm going to walk around it really quickly because you probably have seen the previous video. If you have not, you can click in the top right corner if you want to check out that video. Today it's just going to be on the Autobahn and we're going to see what that is like and what the difference is. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to receive updates when we upload a new video. And check us out on Instagram if you like for some behind the scenes footage. So here we go, yellow extended aero pack, upgraded AP Racing brakes, fake taxi livery, big ass wing, nice exhaust, Poseidon, upside down, Trident, A45 RS badge or logo, and inside we have a full Club Sport roll cage because they do a lot of testing with this car on the Nürburgring. It also has KW Club Sport suspension, which they developed together with KW for this car, on this car. So this was the development car for that suspension setup. Now, the last time I drove it, I said that I felt like the torque vectoring was a bit more present because it really turned hard when you hit the throttle. And Alex, the guy from Poseidon, just told me that when he drives it on the Nürburgring, you actually have, when you start understeering, you actually have to increase the throttle because then it will send you round. He also told me that they have set up the suspension like this, so the front end is a lot higher than the rear end, and that is also why I felt that torque vectoring working so hard, because the front end is much lighter basically than stock. So let's start it up and we'll get going. So the power figure right now is officially TÜV approved 465 horsepower and 600 newton meters, and it is not more than that. So it's not 500 horsepower and 630 newton meters, no. It is officially 465 and 600 newton meters. Okay. Having said that, let's see what it feels like. We're just going to put it in race mode, keep the gearbox in automatic mode, and here we go. Full throttle. It is a seriously quick car. That exhaust blowing away because of the completely empty rear of this car. And I have to say that the suspension on this Autobahn is really good. It is quite bumpy, but last time it was really bumpy. Those brakes are so good. Oh yes, I love those brakes so much. Those AP Racings are really, really strong. Yeah, this car is so, really so aggressive and on edge. It's really cool. It's pretty quick as well, although you do feel that from 100 to 200 is really quick. We actually measured it at 8.8 seconds, so that is quite a bit faster than stock, almost a second, which is pretty respectable. But after 200 and near 250, you can feel that the power is, well, it's not decreasing, but you can feel that the increase is not as big as before, and that is because Alex just told us it's basically the limit of the turbocharger. So that is why you can feel that it's not as strong as before, because that's just, oh man, oh man. Yeah, this car, oh, is seriously one of the nicest handling cars I've driven this year, especially on that B road. Back in the previous review, that B road, I mean, it is so, so nice and poised and light, agile. It's really, really good. Okay, flooring it. And we're going to stay on the left lane because the right lane has those truck tracks. So this car is quite sensitive to that, so I'm keeping it here. Something. I couldn't overtake those cars anyway. Okay, so we'll do another little pull from like 100 kilometers an hour, full throttle, fourth gear. Oh, you can see the car moving back to the left lane. So apparently in this car there are three CUs. So you've got the ECU for the engine, you've got the TCU for the transmission, and then you've got the PTCU for the powertrain. And apparently, you know, they've cracked the PTCU and the ECU now and are able to give it, you know, this nice amount of horsepower and make it run properly. But the TCU, the transmission, is still a work in progress, so they are still trying to get in there to tune it, which should improve this car even further. Oh my god, that torque vectoring is so powerful. It just pushes that right rear to that apex. It's so strong. It's really cool. So Alex has done like 200 laps in this car on a Nürburgring. I mean, that's a good job to have, right? Okay, little tunnel. It's quite loud, actually. Oh! Jesus. Man, this car is, it handles so well. Which is, it's such an improvement over the stock car. Oh man, what a good car. This, with this ECU tune, it's even better than before. Like I said, a tuning box is always going to be a compromise. This ECU tune is just the best way to do it. Now, because of that limited turbocharger, or reaching the limit of the turbocharger, the guys at Poseidon are going to have a turbocharger upgrade kit available for this car, which should be cool as well. And we are going to test that, of course, later on. So when they have that ready and developed, they are going to take this car to us again, and it should deliver over 500 horsepower. So stay tuned for that. For now, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You can also check out this video, check out this playlist, and I hope to see you at the next one. Bye, guys.